In today's tutorial, we're going to take a look at how you can customize your 3D inspections in Trimble RealWorks. This is useful if you would like to customize the colors pertaining to certain intervals rather than the ones built into Trimble RealWorks. Be sure to check out our previous two inspection tutorials. We go over model-to-cloud inspections and cloud-to-cloud inspections. For this tutorial, we're going to use our model-to-cloud inspection. Let's highlight our 3D inspection layer. Then head to the Inspection tab and choose 3D Inspection Analyzer. With the Inspection Analyzer, we have some basic options to filter the cloud using the provided histogram. We can use this to keep points within a certain range. To begin customizing your legend, click on this icon right here, and a new dialog will appear. The first checkbox controls whether we'd like to see our changes in real time. If you have a very large inspection with many points, turning off this option can help speed up your processing time. You will have to switch it back on to see any of your changes though. We can add a title to our inspection to help differentiate it from the others. Just to jump ahead, inspections can be imported and exported from RealWorks. This way, you can apply the same settings to multiple different inspection maps. To pull up existing color bars, simply head to this drop-down menu and select the one that you'd like to use. You can also export them to share with other users or import to different versions of RealWorks. Under the name input, we have some preset options. The first allows you to create an unsigned rainbow color bar. This means it will color the values from 0 and up, which is what we have in this case. The next is a signed rainbow color bar. This works for inspections that have both positive and negative values. The color blue is assigned to 0. Then we have the two color signed bar, which also works for positive and negative values, but ranges between two different colors. We can also specify the number of intervals either by measurement or number of levels. When we specify the measurement increment, we can see that RealWorks automatically calculates the new number of color levels. If we specify the number of levels we want, then RealWorks will automatically calculate the measurement levels. In addition to pre-made color bars, RealWorks also allows you to heavily customize your color bar to your liking. This can be useful if you'd like more detail for certain ranges than others. It can also be helpful for certain situations, such as class detection between objects. In the Edit section, you'll see a color bar with three slider controls. To edit the intervals, first ensure that the top radial button is selected. This will enable you to position the sliders without altering the bar. We will use the middle slider to indicate which interval we want to work with. Now, use the other two sliders to adjust the range in which you'd like to alter. For example, if we just want to alter one section, then we'll place the other two sliders on each side of the middle one. Once they're positioned, click on the second radial button. Now, by moving the middle slider, you can change the range that a particular color is assigned to. As I move the slider, you'll see the bar, legend, and cloud change to reflect the adjustment. Again, we'll switch radial buttons and can reposition the sliders to alter another one. As I mentioned, the left and right sliders indicate the range that you are altering. Let's move both outward and see how that affects the controls. Now we have one all the way to the left and the other almost to the right. Our midpoint is the point of adjustment. When we toggle the second radial button and move the midpoint, you'll see that we can change multiple ranges with respect to the midpoint that we indicated. None of the values outside the left and right sliders will be altered. This allows you to quickly alter many colors, but still retain some level of control. We can do this by sliding or specifying a specific number. RealWorks will find the closest pertaining to your set intervals. Finally, we have more advanced options. If we click them, another dialog box will appear. Here, you can specify unique colors to each one of your ranges. For example, maybe you'd like part of the legend to be a rainbow, then certain values to have a specific color. You can choose from the color palette or use the other option to determine a more unique color. You can also sample or define your own RGB values. We talked a little bit about importing and exporting color bars earlier. Here, I will show you how we can do this. Click the Export button when you're ready and choose a name and location for the file. RealWorks saves its color bar files as a simple ASCII text file. When we open this up, you'll see it contains the information of the color and intervals pertaining to what we set inside the software. Once you've saved your inspection file, you can re-import it into RealWorks or share it with other users if you might have multiple members working on the same project. And that is how you customize the 3D inspections in Trimble RealWorks. If you have any questions, comments, or feedback, please be sure to drop them in the comments below. And as always, be sure to follow along for more RealWorks tips.